And this is how we do average velocity. All we care about is the final position and then also the initial position, and then we just subtract them. So we can get the change in position. And then we divide it by the length of the time interval, namely the change in time. That's pretty much it. So let me just write this down for you guys. Average velocity, all in all, we're just doing the change in position over the change in time, namely the length of the time interval. And right here, the change in position, a lot of people like to call it the displacement, right? So we can also say it's a displacement over the length of the time interval. That's fine too. Well, to find the change in position, all you care about is just two things, the final position and then the initial position. So in notation right here, I will write down S, right, because that's our position function, at the final time that you're talking about. So let me put down TF, the final time, right? So this right here will be my final time. And then I will just have to minus the position at the initial time. So I'll just put on TI. And then for the change in time, of course, you can just do this minus that to find out the length of the time interval. So it's just TF minus TI. And that's it. And notice this is nothing but just the slope formula of the endpoints. That's all. And of course, we can just finish this up real quick. TF is 5, so on the top here, we are calculating S of 5, and then minus S of 0, and then over 5 minus 0. That's pretty much it. And to get S of 5, I just had to plug in 5 into the position function, and I'll just do the computation on the side. So let me put this down right here. This is just some scratch paper work. S of 5. Right? And I will plug in the 5 into the function. And just work this out, you know, just do whatever you want to work this out, you get 20. Okay? So that's going to be 20. And then let's also put down S of 0. And S of 0 is nice number 0. So you can see that this is just 20 minus 0 over 5 minus 0. Work this out, you just get 4. Before I do this, take a guess. Do you think that the average speed, is this easier or harder than that? It's weird, right? And once again, do not just take the absolute value of this and then say the average speed is also 4. That's not the case. That only works if you have instantaneous speed. And here is how we find the speed. Just recall, back in your algebra class, remember your teacher will tell you distance is equal to speed times time, right? This is the good formula that we have seen back in the algebra days. And if you care about speed, you can just divide both sides by t. So you're talking about speed is equal to distance over time, right? Like 60 miles per hour when you drive on the freeway or something. Well, this distance, it's a total distance traveled. So for the average speed, this right here, total distance traveled. And then the denominator is just the length of the time interval. So I will just put down the total time that you are talking about, right? So in this case, the total time is just 5. To figure out the total distance traveled, we have to look at the velocity function. So I will just put this down right here. Okay, I will just write this down right here. Note, I'll do this right here in blue. Because this right here, if you graph it with a calculator or something, whatever, you will see that the positions that go up, down, and up. And this is the idea. You walk forward sometimes, and then you walk backwards. Well, the displacement of this is 0 because I came back to the original position. But I did walking. So maybe it's like 1 meter and then back, I walk 2 meters. You have to consider that. So this is not easy to do in comparison with that. And in order for us to figure out the total distance traveled, we have to pay attention to when did I stop. Once again, if I walk forward, in order for me to go back, I will have to stop at this point and then move backwards. So I care about where is the stopping point. And to do the stopping point, I will have to rely on the velocity function. So I will tell you guys, we know S of t is that, therefore phi of t is equal to, just do the derivative of this, and we will get 3t squared minus 12t plus 9. And I would like to know at rest, okay, in order for me to figure out when did I stop, and usually people just say, okay, what time is the particle at rest? We set this equal to 0, because at that instant, and this right here will give you the instantaneous velocity. This is nice, okay? And if you set the velocity function to be 0, you will be able to find out at what time is the particle at rest. So you go like this, stop, and then go wrong back. All right, so this right here is the algebra. We can just factor out the 3 first, and you get 3t squared minus 4t plus 3. And we want to look for 0, so this is t minus 1, t minus 3 equals to 0. And from here, you can see that t has to be 1, and from here, you can see that t has to be 3. So you care about 1 and 3 as well. At this 2 time, the particle is at rest. And from here, let me just draw a picture for you guys. So imagine this right here is my position. So this is the S. And let's say this is the initial position. Because at time is equal to 0, you can imagine the particle is like me right here. Okay? And I know earlier I walked this way, but that's my positive direction. But usually, we look at the right as the positive direction, as always, right? So this right here is the position. All right, here is the deal. Originally, S of 0 is 0. That means this particle is at 0, right? So let me indicate t is equal to 0 right here. Next, you have to figure out S of 1. And S of 1 is similar. And let me just put this down right here. Because I care about the position, so I will write this down right here. Like, who doesn't care about the position, right? S of 1. Do not plug in 1 into the velocity. You get 0, because we did that. You're plugging 1 into the S function right here. And you can work this out. You get 4. And what does this 4 represent? This 4 tells you at time is equal to 1, you are right here at 4. So you pretty much went from here to here during the first second. So this is t is equal to 1. So how far do you travel? 4 meters. Okay? So from here to here, 4 meters. And now let's see S of 3, what happens? And you have to keep in mind, from here to here, at time is equal to 1, we stop right here at this particular instant. We have two situations. The first situation is that maybe I will keep moving this way. Or the other situation is that I could have turned and go back. Because when I stop, let's say right here, I have two choices. I can keep going forward, or earlier when I stopped right here, I can decide to turn around and then walk backwards. Right? So keep that in mind. But don't worry if you draw a diagram right here. That will take care of you. All right, and the number will also take care of us as well. Let's take a look. Plugging 3 into all the t's, the answer to this is 0. Now, what does this mean? This means at time is equal to 3. In fact, we went back to position 0. So I will have to do this for you guys. We will go back like this. And then at t is equal to 3, we came back here, right? You can imagine it's like, okay, class is over. I'm going to go back home. But after 1 second or so, I forgot that I forgot my backpack, right? I realized I forgot my backpack. So I had to turn around, go back to the classroom, and then at this point, I stopped to grab my bag or something. And what happens is that S of 5, meaning from t is equal to 3, I'm still right here, and t is equal to 5, the position is 20, which is, let's say, it's right here. That means I will have to turn around and then go this way up to here. And maybe this is where my house is. So I will draw a picture. This is where I am at when t is equal to 5. Okay, now take a look. How far have we gone? Let's see, how far we have traveled? 4 meters, another 4 meters, and then 20 meters, right? So 4, 4, 20, right? Therefore, what's the total distance traveled? Let me put this down right here. Total distance during the first 5 seconds is 4 plus 4 plus 20. And of course, that's 28. And this is during t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 5, right? During the first 5 seconds. And with this picture, took us some time, we see that the total distance traveled is nothing but just the answer we got, which is 28. And then divided by the total time that we are talking about during this time interval, which is just 5 minus 0, which is 5. Divide, do it whichever way that you like, you get 5.6. And this is also, this is the speed, so we should also give the unit, and namely we will have meters per second. Right, so this right here is how we do average speed at the moment. Anyway, hopefully this video helps. And comment down below if you have any questions. And as always, that's it.